So if the intensities are represented in the ranges 0 to 1, 0 to 1 both, then the relation between both these are directly, that is inversely proportional, right? So thereby we have to subtract them by 1. So for printing and art industry, the CMY model is not enough. So thereby we add a fourth color of K to the CMY model, where K stands for black color. Luminance, in phase and quadrature color model. The YIQ color model is a recording of RGB color model. Is also used for television broadcasting. The Y channel contains luminance information sufficient for black and white television sets, and I channel and Q channel contains color information, that is in phase and quadrature for color informations. For recording RGB to YIQ, HSV and HLS color models are used. In phase, we produce by subtracting red with yellow, and quadrature by subtracting blue with yellow. This model was designed to separate chrominance from luminance. This was a requirement in the early days of color television, when black and white sets still were expected to pick up and display what are originally color pictures. The Y channel contains luminance information sufficient for black and white television sets, as said above, while the I and Q channels in phase and in quadrature carried the color information. A color television set would take these three channels YIQ and map the information back to RGB levels for display on the screen. So there were standard coordinates, coordinate points to convert RGB conversion to YIQ. YIQ was formerly used in North America, Japan and elsewhere television broadcasts for historical reasons. This system stores a luminance value with two chrominance values correspondingly approximately to the amounts of blue and red in the column. It corresponds closely to the YUV scheme used in Australia, Europe, except France, which uses a different scheme. Television, except that the YIQ color space is rotated 33 degrees with respect to the YUV color space. The next one is HSV, hue, saturation value, and HLS, hue, lightness, saturation color model. HSV and HLS are the two most common cylindrical coordinate representation of points in the RGB color model. RGB and CMY color model, that is, models are hardware oriented models. In contrast, HSV color model is user oriented. It uses color descriptions that have a more intuitive appeal to a user. The color specification in HSV model can be given by selecting a spectral color and the amounts of white and black that are to be added to obtain different shades, tints and tones. This model uses three color parameters, hue, saturation and value, hue distinguishes among colors such as red, green, purple and yellow. Saturation refers to how far color is from a gray of equal intensity. For example, red is highly saturated, whereas pink is relatively unsaturated. The value V indicates the level of brightness. This model uses a cylindrical coordinate system, and the subset of the space within which model is defined is a hexagon or six-sided pyramid, as shown in this HSV figure. The top of the hex cone is derived from the RGB cube. If we imagine viewing the cube along the main diagonal from the white vertex to the origin black, we see an outline of the cube that has the hexagon shape as shown in this figure. This boundary of cube is used as a top if hexagon and its represents varies, that is varies whose. Who or H is measured by the angle around the vertical axis with the red at 0 degree, green at 120 degree as shown in the figure. Complementary colors in the HSV hex cone or 180 degree apart saturation parameter varies from 0 to 1. Its value is the ratio ranging from 0 on the center line V-axis to 1 on the triangular sides of the hexagon. The value V varies from 0 at the apex of the hexagon to 1 at the top. The apex represents black. At the top of the hexagon, colors have their maximum intensity. When V is equal to 1 and S is equal to 1, we have the pure hues. For example, pure red is at H is equal to 0, V is equal to 1 and S is equal to 1. Pure green is at H is equal to 120, V is equal to 1, S is equal to 1. Pure blue is at H is equal to 240, V is equal to 1 and S is equal to 1 and so on. You can look at from the this particular picture. So the required color can be obtained by adding either white or black to the pure hue. Black can be added to the selected hue by decreasing the setting for V while S is held constant. On the other hand, white can be added to the selected hue by decreasing S while keeping V constant. To add some black and some white, we have to decrease both V and S. So the point S is equal to 0 and V is equal to 1, we have white color. The intermediate values of V for S is equal to 0 on the center line are gray shades. When S is equal to 0, the value of H is irrelevant. When S is not 0, H is relevant. At the apex, V coordinate is 0. At this point, the values of H and S are irrelevant. As shown in if the cross-sectional plane of HSV hexagon, this plane represents the color concepts associated with the terms shades, tints and tones. We can add black color to the pure hue to produce different shades of the color. White color to pure hue to produce different tints of the color. Both white and black color to pure hue to produce tones of the color. Next, coming to HLS model, another model based on intuitive color parameters is the HLS color model used by Tektronix. The three color parameters in this model are hue, lightness and saturation. It is represented by double hexagon as shown in this particular picture. The hue specifies the angle around the vertical axis of the double hexagon. In this model, H is equal to 0 degree corresponds to blue. The remaining colors are specified around the perimeter of the hexagon in the same order as in the HSV model. Magenta is at 60 degree, red is at 20 degree and yellow is at H is equal to 180 degree. Complementary colors are 180 degree apart on the double hexagon. The vertical axis in this model represents the lightness. At L is equal to 0, we have black and at L is equal to 1, we have white. In between value of L, we have gray levels. The saturation parameter S varies from 0 to 1 and it specifies relative purity of a color. At S is equal to 0, we have the grayscale and at S is equal to 1 and L is equal to 0.5, we have maximum saturated pure hue. As S decreases, the hue saturation decreases, that is hue becomes less pure. In HLS model, a hue can be selected by selecting hue angle H and the desired shade, tint or tone can be obtained by adjusting L and S. The colors can be made lighter by increasing L and can be made darker by decreasing L. The colors can be moved towards gray by decreasing S. Hue means color is mapped into 0 minus 360 degree. The wavelength of hue is 128. The saturation is defined in the ranges of 0 to 1. In this, the amount of white color is 130. Value is defined between the ranges 0 to 1. In this, the amount of black color is 23. So this is an example comparison on various different models output based on their proportions of different models on colors. So coming to the color selection, many graphics packages offer three main methods of selecting color. These are selection for a graphical palette, selection by specifying the red, blue and green content, selection by specifying the hue, saturation and value. All the three can be used to select a color. Thus, one may use the palette to point to a pale blue. Decide to add a little more red to it in RGB selector and then reduce its purity in the saturation slider. We can use color wheel, the graphical representation of the components of color, to select color. It illustrates that we can consider any color to be the combination of three primaries and black and white. We can obtain that points to be remembered while selection of color is, we can obtain well matched color by selecting a color at regular intervals along any straight line within RGB or CMY cube. Randomly selected hue may produce harsh and clashing color combinations. It is important to note that different colors are perceived at different depths. This occurs because human eyes focus on colors according to their frequency. Blue pattern next to a red pattern can cause eye fatigue because switching from one area to the other needs continuous refocusing. This problem can be reduced by separating these colors or by using colors from one half or less of the color hexagon in the HSV model. Use of a lesser number of colors produces a more pleasing display than using a large number of colors. For background color, most suitable color is the complement of one of the foreground color or a gray color.